This week we have talked about the martyrs. We have talked about those that are willing to witness to the point of death. And Jesus had actually told them that this was what was going to happen to them. He's never told any of us that. But how far would we go when it comes to our faith? We've saved this story for the end. There was a gentleman by the name of James the Great. He is the half-brother of John. They have different fathers. John that we talked about earlier this week. And James had the opportunity to not step away from his faith, but all he had to do was question his faith. He was going before Herod. He had the opportunity to do so, and he just had to question it. Just question it for all these other people. And he chose not to do it. So they said, that's fine, we're going to behead you. But before they beheaded him, and listen to this and watch this, because this is faith. The chief accuser of James stepped in and said, I believe. To which they had to turn to him and say, how could you possibly believe after all this? You're the one who accused him. And he said, if he is willing to take this step for his faith, it has to be true. And so if you're going to kill him, you have to kill me. And so James and his chief accuser were beheaded together. See, as a witness, many times we feel we have to know every single word of the Bible. And yet we gave you some stuff to read, but we didn't share a lot of verses within this time. Because when it comes to our faith, it's living out in front of other people so they get to the edge and say, what is different about you? How is it that you can stand for your faith in all adversity? And that is because we focus on the eternal and not the temporary. And so when James lost his head, his chief accuser lost his head as well. And because of their belief, they now rest in eternity. And eternity is what is on the line. And that is what being a witness is truly about. Get people to the edge and make them want to know, and then for them to take that step of faith, which is a step of life. We'll see you tomorrow for the rest of it.